Neil Kinnock spent much longer than expected at Haringey Civic Centre, meeting councillors and senior police officers. Then it was on to the main business of the day, a visit to Broadwater Farm to see for himself conditions there. First he went to the local play centre, then to a meeting at the Youth Association with tenants and youth representatives. Afterwards he made it clear what he thought was needed.
I think that there still are tensions. I think that on both sides there are people working in order to reduce the sources of those tensions. And I further think that the government could actively assist in this positive process, both so far as the council is concerned and so far as the police and the community are concerned.
Haringey's Labour leader Bernie Grant caused a sensation after the October riot by saying the police had got a bloody good hiding. Mr Kinnock distanced himself from those remarks then and refused to be drawn further today.
I've made my views on that absolutely clearly and directly known in the period, in the days indeed, following those disturbances on Broadwater Farm. I don't think that there's anything particularly productive in adding to that.
Despite this assurance, Neil Kinnock's visit has angered Tottenham Tories.
Well, there can only be one reaction, and that is that Neil Kinnock supports Bernie Grant, that the Labour Party support him, all the councillors, the Labour councillors support Bernie Grant, and Neil Kinnock must, he's never condemned the fact that Bernie Grant personally has not regretted the death of the policeman.
Haringey's Labour administration see this as a red herring. Much more important, they say, is rate capping issue, which has hit them hard. They know they have an ally in the Labour leader, but whether he'll ever be in a position to redress the balance remains to be seen. Today he was long on sympathy, short on hard promises. Paul Green in Tottenham for Thames News.